بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. الله سبحانه وتعالى says في كتابه الكريم: النبي أولى بالمؤمنين من أنفسهم وأزواجه أمهاتهم. This is in Surah Al-Ahzab. Allah سبحانه وتعالى makes clear for us that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is closer to the believers than their own selves, and his wives are their mothers. The believing women, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, Khadija, and the rest of the Ummahat al-Mu'mineen, they are more beloved to Ahl Sunnah than our own selves. They were the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they'll be with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Jannah, as was narrated in authentic ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And it's a very strange thing that you would have a people arise who would make it a part of their foundation and creed to curse and make takfir and to declare any one of the believing women to be adulteresses. First and foremost, the Ummahat al-Mu'mineen, the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This insinuates that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't know how to choose his wives, the one who received wahy and revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and revelation was revealed about the believing women. But yet some people make it their creed, in fact, their belief, their foundation, what they wake up in the morning as a part of their internal being and self and ideology, which forms how they interact with others, to curse the believing women. وَعِيَادَ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ضَلَالٍ. This type of misguidance and evil, which we find amongst the Rafida Shia, not all Shia hold this evil and wicked and innovated belief. This is not just innovation in the religion, but innovation is of two types. There's bid'ah mukaffara wa bid'ah ghayr mukaffara. There is innovation that takes you out of the fold of Islam. So it's an innovation in the religion, but it expels you from the fold of Islam. It could be something extreme in creed, or it could be something, an action, which is so extreme, maybe grave worship or something like this. Then these actions are bid'ah mukaffara. Then there is bid'ah ghayr mukaffara. This is the type of innovation which is sinful, which is wicked, but it leaves the person who does this type of innovation is still a Muslim, a sinful mubtadi'ah, a person who innovates in the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as if to say that they have something better to offer than what Allah tabarak wa ta'ala revealed, or what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with. Salawatu Rabbi wa salamu alayhi. And may Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is free from these evil ideologies. So these people, let's read what Allama Muhammad Siddiq Hassan Khan rahimahullah ta'ala said in regards to the Rafida. He wrote a very beautiful statement which summarizes for us, because it's more befitting that we mention the statements of the scholars of Ahl Sunnah. And he spoke about the Rafida and Ahl Sunnah's position in general, the believing women, that Ahl Sunnah يحترمون كل ويعظمونهن حق تعظيم وحق وهو حق البحث وكذلك يتعرفون بعظمة أولاده صلى الله عليه وسلم من فاطمة الزهراء رضي الله تعالى عنها ويذكرونهم جميعا بالخير ودعاء. That Ahl Sunnah, they give full respect to all of the believing women, to all of the mothers of the believers, meaning the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Ahl al-Bayt. Ahl al-Sunnah believes this. And that they give all of them their rights and love them and raise them to a high status that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them. And that Ahl al-Sunnah is aware of the greatness of the children of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, like Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha. And Ahl al-Sunnah only mentions the Sahaba in general with khair and goodness, especially the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or inclusive of them, and makes dua, we supplicate for them, not to them, but for them. We supplicate to Allah for them, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. And we know the sacredness of the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, al-mutahhirat, faqad khalaf zahir al-Qur'an wa sariya nas minhu. This is the Shia. The Shaykh Allama mentioned that the Shia, the Rafida, they don't recognize the sacredness of the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and their purity, and they have differed with the open and apparent meaning of the Quran. What it there is no la yahtamil shay'an akhar. It doesn't have any other meaning. That the meaning is very clear. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the Prophet is closer to the believers than their own selves, and his wives are their mothers. How could the Rafida and Shia, those people who curse Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, and others from the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, do not recognize their fadl, their greatness, and their high esteem in Islam, and that they are the mothers of the believers, as Allah said? What do you have that, what is your hujjah when Allah says that? That's disgraceful and sick. That's sickness. You're sick, anyone who holds this wicked and evil belief based on kufr wa zandaka. وَعْيَادَ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala curse those people who curse Aisha and belittle them and witness and bless us to be of those, to have them under our feet. This is a wicked, satanic belief. The Shaykh goes on to say, rahimahullah ta'ala, وَمَنْ فَرَقَ بَيْنَهُنَّ وَقَالَ بِشَرْفْ بَعْدَهُنَّ وَلَمْ يَقُلْ بِالْأُخْرِ فَهُوَ رَافِدِي خَبِيثِ رِجِسْ لِأَنَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ سَاقُهُنَّ فِي الْقُرْآنِ فِي مَسَاقْ وَاحِدْ. The Shaykh went on to say that whoever distinguishes and differs between the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is the ones who differ or distinguish between them. You know, distinguishing, saying that some are not beloved to us and others are, you know, and belittle others. That whoever distinguishes in this respect and belittles some of them and gives high status to others and doesn't say that others have this high status, then he is a Rafidi. You know, those people who reject, they reject the religion, they reject the deen of Ahl al-Sunnah, they reject what the authentic creed has, which comes from the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Fahim al-Salaf al-Saleh. They reject this. They're khabith. Yani, they are wicked, filthy, rijis. Rijis has many different meanings, and one of it is that it's filth, rijis shaitan, that it's the filth or the evil and of the shaitan. لأنه سبحانه ساقهن. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, mentioned them all, included them all in the verse, and he did not distinguish between any one of them, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, radiyallahu ta'ala anhunna ajma'in. So, and then the Shaykh said, وَمَاذَا بَعْدَ الْحَقِّ إِلَّا الضَّلَالِ. And after the truth, what is there except misguidance? This is the case of the Rafida. This is the case of the Shia. This is the case of Ahl al-Zandaqa, wa Ahl al-Kufr, wa Ahl al-Filth, and the people of deception and evil. Talbis al-Iblis, these people who deceive and try to mix truth with falsehood. This is their case. They can't. How can you argue with the Quran? Even they try to argue with Allah. These people are so filthy, they try to argue with Allah. How do they do it? They belittle the Quran and they say the Quran is not even, they say the Quran is created. They say the Quran is been tampered with. So they don't even believe in the Quran. So how is it possible that you can debate with a Shia? How can you debate with him? Your masdar, your origin, your source isn't even the same. We're Muslim. We take from the Quran and the Sunnah. They take from their books, their imams. They worship men. وَعِيَادَ بِاللَّهِ. Idolatry. They are worse than the Jews and the Christians. They are أكثر من يهود ونصارى, as Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah said. They have more disbelief, more kufr than the يهود ونصارى. So أيها المسلمون, never pray behind someone you know is a Rafidi. Never. Your prayer is not accepted. This person doesn't even worship Allah. They worship their imams if they're 12 imamers. They worship their imams and believe they're infallible. How is it that you're going to pray behind someone who worships Khomeini and says he's infallible? And all these other khaba'ith. A'udhu billah min al-khubthi wa khaba'ith. I seek refuge in Allah from the wicked shayateen, from the men and from men, the female and male shayateen. We seek refuge in Allah from them and their wicked, wicked belief. وَعْيَاذَ مِنْلَّهِ. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil, and to belittle and make all of the Rafida to enter the fold of Islam and hold the correct creed, worshipping Allah and staying away from kufr wa zandaqa. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by all of His divine names and attributes to help and bless Ahl Sunnah wherever they may be. And رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين, on all the Sahaba. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase their status in Jannah to Firdaus. And may Allah bless us to be of those people to see the Sahaba to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannah to Firdaus. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send His curses upon those people who curse the Sahaba. رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين, وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد.